This is Cruise News Today with Doug Parker.
A river pilot fell to his death while boarding the Diamond Princess off the coast of Nagasaki, Japan. The incident happened when he was climbing the ladder from the pilot boat to the ship. The crew of the Diamond Princess reacted swiftly, deploying a rescue boat to retrieve the pilot. However, he did not survive the fall. The Japanese Coast Guard is investigating the cause of the fall, although witnesses say that the pilot boat shook, causing the accident. The pilot had nearly two decades of piloting experience. River pilots play a crucial role in guiding ships safely through local waterways. Diamond Princess was on an 8-day cruise from Yokohama during the incident. And Disney Magic is back in service after a 3-week renovation at Grand Bahama Shipyard in Bahamas. The ship now has a new Encanto entertainment experience, as well as a new soul-themed jazz lounge. Additionally, the concierge lounge on Magic now has a new Moana theme, and all concierge suites have been refurbished. Disney Magic is currently sailing from San Juan, Puerto Rico, and will soon be homeported in Miami for the summer. And finally, after a 3-year hiatus, the Queen Mary Hotel is back in operation. The permanently docked ocean liner located in Long Beach, California, was closed to hotel guests for 3 years due to the pandemic and then critical repair work. The current price per night for a stateroom is $169 for a cabin with a porthole. The reopening of the hotel comes just a month after 3 guided tours resumed on April 1st. And cruise line stocks were mixed on Wednesday. Carnival Corporation down 1.5%, 10.49. Royal Caribbean flat 77.15. And Norwegian flat 14.08. Breaking news in this week's podcast, a review of Royal Caribbean's Navigator of the Seas at cruiseradio.net. I'm Doug Parker with Cruise News Today.
Cruise News Today is a production of Cruise Radio. Behind-the-scenes content and extras are now available at patreon.com/cruiseradio